साइंटिफिक कुकिंग पार्ट वन कुकिंग साइंस। प्रिमिटिव मैन यूज्ड टू ईट रॉ फूड लाइक एनिमल फ्लेश, फ्रूट्स, ट्यूबर्स, नट्स, सुगर केन एटसेट्रा। हियर द प्रिमिटिव मैन इज कुकिंग हिज फूड एनिमल फ्लेश इन द फ्लेम। साइंटिफिक कुकिंग पार्ट वन कुकिंग साइंस। मैन नीड्स फूड शेल्टर एंड रेस्ट फॉर हिज सर्वाइवल, फूड फॉर एनर्जी एंड ग्रोथ, शेल्टर फॉर सिक्योरिटी एंड रेस्ट फॉर एलिमिनेशन ऑफ वेस्ट एंड रेसिस्टेंस। Heat is very important for cooking food. Let us know about heat loss. First law is heat always flows from high temperature to low temperature regions. And second law, heat flows in three ways. Number one, conduction of heat. Number two, convection of heat, and number three, radiation of heat. Let us know about the first law. If we put an iron rod in a flame, heat flows from high temperature to low temperature regions. Here in this flame, at the end of this rod, it is having high temperature. At another end, it is having low temperature. Heat flows from this high temperature region to low temperature regions. This is the first law. Here, the heat is conducting in an iron rod from high temperature to low temperature. And the second law is, heat flows in three ways: conduction, convection, and radiation. Conduction. Conduction is possible in solid metals like iron, copper, aluminium, etc. And in this process, molecules do not move. They will be static at their own places. See one example. If we put an iron rod in a flame, first they were heated, and these molecules, they transfer to the second row of the molecules, and second row molecules, they transfer heat from to the third row molecules. Likewise, molecules transfer these heat from one end to another end. In this process, molecules do not move. They are at their own places. Here, in this conduction, molecules are not moving from one place to another place. Let us take one example. Here, the persons are carrying bricks from one place to another place. We can compare these bricks as heat and the persons as molecules. First, heat is transferred to the first molecules. First molecule, that means first person, he takes a brick and he gives that brick to the second person, and second person takes that brick and he gives it to the third person, third person gives to fourth person, fourth person gives to fifth person,
6% at the end of the place. This is the heat transferred from this place to this place. Here the persons do not move. They only transfer the bricks from one person to another person.
Here the persons are shifting the bricks without changing their places.
Let us see another transmission of heat, that is convection. Convection, it takes place in liquids. Heat transmits in liquids in the process of convection. And in this convection process, molecules move from one place to another place. These molecules, they carry heat and moves from one place to another place. Let us see one example. Brick carrying example. Here this is one end and this is another end. First end, second end. And the person are compared with molecules and the bricks are compared with heat source. Here this person is carrying brick and he is going to the other end with the brick, that means with the heat. Molecules, they transfer heat from one place to another place. And at the other end, in the second end, these molecules, this person is not having a brick. And this person, these molecules are not having heat. They come to this first end and they carry these bricks or heat and go to the second end.
Here, the persons are moving for shifting the bricks.
Here take another example. This is a beaker and this is a Bunsen burner. Take some water in this beaker and you flame this Bunsen burner. After some time, the water will be heated. Molecules beneath the, that means under this place, hot molecule, and these molecules, they take heat first. First they take heat, these molecules first take heat and they become lighter and they go upwards, and on upper surface there are cool molecules, they are heavy molecules, they come down, they come downwards and the hot molecules goes upwards. That's why the molecules move from one place to another place, from this place to this place. Hot molecules from this place to this place and cool molecules from upper place to down.
Here hot molecules are going upward and cool molecules are coming downwards.
Another type of heat transmission is radiation. Radiation in this process, it does not require any molecules it is possible in the space. It requires no matter. It requires no medium. Without medium, heat transfers from one place to another place. It doesn't require any molecules. This is called radiation. Here, see the sun. The sun is the heat source in this universe. And this is Earth. This is Earth is receiving end, and this sun is producing end. Heat transfers from this heat source to the receiving end Earth. Here, around the Earth there is atmosphere. Air is there. Air and atmosphere is there around the Earth. This is the medium. It is having molecules. It is having molecules, and above this atmosphere there is no molecules and there is no medium. This is space. In this space also heat transfers from sun to the Earth.
Here, without mediated persons, the bricks are shifting.
Now, we see applicability of heat loss in cooking. We have to apply heat loss in cooking. Here is a general process of cooking. It is a general process, not the specific process. Generally, we can follow these steps in cooking food. Flame. Flame is having high temperature when compared to pan or vessel. That's why heat transfers from flame to pan. Pan is having oil. Oil is having less temperature. Pan is having high temperature. That's why heat transfers from pan to oil. In the pan, heat transfers in the process of conduction. While in oil, the heat transfers in the process of convection. After the oil is heated, then we have to add spices. Spices are dried in the form. That's why they are having less amount of water. Spices like mustard seeds, cumin seeds, Bengal gram, urad dal, like that, we can add any type of spice according to our recipe. After the spices are fried up, it gives a good smell because proteins in the spices split into amino acids. Amino acids give us a good smell. That's why we can recognize that spices are fried up. And also they give a sound, chitpat, the splitting sound. We can hear the splitting sound of spices. That's why we can recognize that spices are fried up. After frying the spices, we have to add onions. I will upload different recipes in my next videos. If you like this video, like it, share it, and press the subscribe button. Subscribe button is under this video. If you subscribe my channel, you can see my videos at first. Thank you.